company is run by the fourth generation, so it is still family owned. Okay. Now, Royal Selangor makes Pewter products, alright, and for Selbren and Collins, they're actually our sister company. So, Selbren, they do fine jewelry, and for Collins, they're making 925 sterling silver products. So, we have our offices located in this country, London, Singapore, Melbourne, Hong Kong, about 400 years ago. So this is money in Malaysia, okay? It is made out of pure tin, and back then the value was based on its weight. More heavy, more expensive, okay? But because these were so heavy to carry in your pocket, right? In your bag, too big as well. So they're changed to use the coins from the money. They can just break it off and use it as money. Yeah, just break it off like that. Alright? Okay.
Actual
size? Yeah, it's actually the actual size. So how do we find tin in the early days? The most traditional way is the turning method, right here. Okay, so this is the most traditional way to mine tin, the panning method. Now back then, the workers would be using the wooden plate here, scoop out the tin ore and swirl it around. Okay, just to throw away the water, the rocks and the sand. And what we want is just the tin by itself. So we just send it over to the factory to be made into tin ingots. Okay, so the tin ingots is made into the size of blocks, easy to export, right? Easy to export to other countries. The huge piece is 45 kilograms, the middle one is 25, and the small one is 5 kilograms. Under Royal Selangor. Yeah. where the filtration process happens. Okay, and we don't want the rocks, the sands, and the water. Everything will be disposed at the end. Yeah. Now, can you imagine the size of the tindrush? It's about the size of 2 football fields. Very huge, yeah, because of the large tindrush. We'll be heading over to the factory soon. So it's a bit warm here. Okay, if it's not bearable, you let me know, yeah? Alright, this way. Okay, before we enter, I have a treat for you. So it's a welcome drink. We have a hundred plus, a sporty drink served in a pewter cup. Right, so when you hold onto the cup later on, it feels cold and chilly because pewter has the characteristic of keeping drinks cold up to half an hour time. And keeping drinks warm up to 1 hour time. So it really depends on what, whether it's a hot or cold beverage. Enjoy yourself. Okay. Help yourself. You can take one and yep, enjoy.
Now our craftsman is using a steel blade to remove layers of the pewter.
to reveal its shine. Right. Now during this process, all the scraps comes off. And these are the ones you see in the museum. Now you can touch it with your bare hands. It's actually pretty soft, so it doesn't hurt your fingers.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So we are melting this down so it could be reduced, no wastage. And now she's using a scotch pad to give it a matte finish, and that's how it's done. Now, do you notice the difference before and after polishing? This is before and this is after.
Mm-hmm.
Few difference here?
Yeah.
Okay. Now later on, we'll be doing the design on it. So this is the final product with the hand hammering design. There you go. Yeah, this cup here has very detailed design, so it needs to go through hand finishing. And we'll be doing it at the third station. Okay, shall we move on? Alright, so on my hands, I have a money tree. Okay, this is a money tree that's just casted. So it's pretty rough around the edges. You see all these edges here, so we don't want them. What our craftsman will do is to use the filing tool to remove the rough edges. Yeah, so this is done by hand. All of our Royal Selangor products, it needs to go through hand finishing process. It's a must. Same goes to the designs around the tea caddies. Now these tea caddies are airtight, so if you're a coffee or a tea lover, it's good to keep coffee beans and tea leaves in it, alright? As I pull it out, you hear a pop sound? Yeah? Okay, so we keep tea leaves in it. It can be coffee beans, it can be spices, alright? Now as I put the lid down, oh, be careful. So make sure you don't push it down, it will damage the lid. Now as you put it down, you put the lid down, and it will slide down by itself. There you go. I will demonstrate it for you. So you put it down, and it will slide down by itself. Because the lid and the opening is made perfectly, it fits well together. Now it pushes all the air out, keeping the ingredients fresh. That's how it works. Same goes to the outer lid. Alright, so this is the hammering station. Now on my hands, I have a cup of 700 meeples, 700 dots here. Now our craftsman, she needs to have twice to form one dot. Means you need to have approximately 1,400 knots to complete this design right here. Okay. So, as you can see, she's applying even pressure onto the knot, and she needs a very good eyesight. Yeah. So, if your hands fall steady, then the knot falls everywhere. The knots go all over the place. Now, in order to master this skill, you need to be trained for 6 months' time. To master this skill right here?
Yes.
And what happens if she makes a mistake? This cup here needs to go back to the hot pot. Undergo all the process again before she will have it. So that's not easy. Yeah. Alright, let's move on to the next station. View of the factory, right? The factory is closed today, it's a public holiday. On usual days, the lights are on. We have about 250 craftsmen in the factory. So this is the only factory of Royal Selangor. So all of our worldwide products are produced here and we shipped it globally. Yeah, so everything is manufactured here. Alright, let's have a look. Well, we have a walk down. So while we're walking, you just have a look on the stations. There are some unfinished products. Some are halfway done, some are ready. He's a visionary man. He expanded this area into 14 acres of land. So currently the company is managed and owned by the fourth generation. Yeah, so it's still a family owned business. So that's pretty much the end of the tour. We are heading over to the showroom now. Okay?